All right. This is Jonesy's Jukebox on KLOS. It's another beautiful day. I'm here with Taylor Hawkins from the Foo Fighters.
How's it going, buddy? All right. Are you a big Zeppelin fan, Jonesy?
Yeah. I love Zeppelin. It's great. Great drummer.
Yep. John Bonham.
That album was recorded at... Was it recorded in Sweden?
Yeah, which... Is that off... That's off the last record.
Was that on Coda?
Yeah, I think that was...
I think it was Coda.
I think it was an outtake from Coda, or from In Through the Outdoor.
Yes, right. In Through the Outdoor.
That's recorded at Polar Studios, which would be ABBA's studio.
Oh, I loved ABBA.
Who doesn't love ABBA?
Everybody loves ABBA. That was done there?
Yeah.
Oh, I like that sound.
It's a good sound. Good drum sound.
That's a great drum sound.
It sounds a lot like ABBA, too. Zeppelin, I mean, I can't believe how much they kind of started sounding like ABBA as soon as they went to their studio.
You can hear it.
Yeah, you can.
You can hear it in there. Especially.
Like a very ABBA sound.
Yeah. In the drums.
Yeah. It's the ABBA drum sound.
Is that what that is?
It's very unmistakable. You can't miss that. That's
right. You know what I've heard?
I see why they went there.
I've heard that your studio that you record in looks a lot like ABBA's.
That's correct. Yes.
Is that true?
My best buddy Dave Grohl, he bought me this ABBA book because he knew I liked ABBA.
Right.
Around the same time we were building.
He's a wanker, by the way.
You caught him on a bad day.
Oh, right. I don't like him.
No. You guys are buddies. Come on. You love him.
Well, hey, I suppose. Maybe a bit.
Anyway, but he's all right. He's a good guy. Anyways, he bought me a book. That's a bro thing to do. He bought me this ABBA book, and it was at the same time we were building our studio, 606, down in beautiful San Fernando Valley, where the air is clean.
Don't tell him where it is.
It's at...
That's not a good... No, don't.
It's in the valley.
You're going to give the
address? It's a big valley. It's a big valley. Yeah, no address.
Right.
We were building it, so we looked at the book, and we liked the way their studio looked and this ABBA book, and therefore... We kind of aped it.
Does it look Scandinavian?
It does. It's got a very, I want a piece of chocolate when I go.
Cheese and herring and things like that.
Yeah, smells like herring, actually.
That's not right. You don't.
That's disgusting.
That's not a good smell in the studio.
No, it's
not. Is it?
No.
No. Well,
at least the studio here that we are at, KLOS, 95.5.
Right. I like a studio that smells nice.
Not fishy.
No, not fishy. It smells like Shilajit.
Have you had Shilajit? No, I've heard about it.
It's a mineral.
Last time we were here, you were eating that.
Yeah.
Like beer nuts.
Oh, it's great.
Do you feel better from it?
It's a mineral.
I know. Does it help you? Is it helping you?
What? Yeah, I feel great.
Good.
I'm on a cleanse. I've been cleansing, because I've got it.
Do you go to get one of those things, where they...
A colonic?
Yeah, they stick a tube
up
your backside.
Right, I've had a colonic
My wife made me go get one once. I did not like it. I felt violated.
Oh. I think they're great. It makes you, it makes you feel
clear.
Right. Makes you feel light. Yeah. All right.
I had a woman give it to me, which was even more gnarly.
Not sure I need to know that, Taylor. But thank you. Thanks.
Thanks for that.
Thanks for that. You're listening to Jonesy's Jukebox. KLOS. We're
95.5.
That's right. We're here with Taylor Hawkins.
Yeah.
And he's picking some songs to listen to.
Well, what do we got queued up right now? Susie Sue and the Banshees.
I remember her.
Yeah, of course.
Right.
Of course you do.
Yeah, back in the day.
Yeah. I think you were.
She was great.
Yeah.
And Susie and the Banshees.
Yeah. She was on the show with you guys when you guys got kicked off the show, right?
I don't remember.
She was.
Was she?
Yeah, she was.
What happened?
Well, you said some bad words.
Who, me?
Yeah, you called Bill Grundy guy a rotter, and among other things.
Oh, right.
You know, that's Queen's fault that you guys were there. That happened.
It was?
Yeah, they were supposed to be there that day. And
explain.
They canceled. It was a... You know.
Yeah, but I like hearing you say it.
Well, it's, you know, it was a TV show, you know, I guess some sort of daytime show.
Right.
Queen were supposed to be on there.
Ah.
And they canceled at the last minute, so they got you guys. And then you got hammered.
I did.
You did.
Maybe that's why I don't remember anything.
There you go. And that's what happened.
Oh.
I think, from what I've read.
And here we are.
And here we are today.
Here we are, playing music on Jonesy's Jukebox.
95.5.
KLOS.
Susie Sue.
Susie Sue.
Let's hear it.
All right. That was Sparks, right?
Yeah. You big Sparks fan?
I like Sparks quite a bit, actually.
Pretty clever. Pretty crazy music, right?
Oh, yeah. I like that. It's great.
Yeah.
The melodies.
How nice it is to be able to hear music like that on the radio, isn't it?
It's one of the great things about having this job is they let me play what I like.
I mean, come on. You never hear Barbara Cutie at 12:30 in the afternoon on a major radio station anywhere.
Do you know what? Every time I hear that name Sparks, makes me think of them underwears that people wear to make the bums look smaller. What's that called? Spanx.
Spanx?
Spanx. That's what it is.
It sparks the idea of Spanx?
Right. Well, you know, I think people wear them to...
make their butt look nice?
Yeah. It squeezes them into funny shapes. Like...
Do you wear them?
Maybe.
Your butt looks nice today, Jonesy.
Thanks, Taylor. I knew I liked you. You're the perfect guest. You think my bum is a nice shape. It's very nice of you. Have you got a song you'd like to play?
Should I play the Genesis song, Illegal Alien?
Right. You're a big Genesis fan, right?
Well, I love Genesis, yeah.
Oh, yeah, they're great.
Yeah, I thought we could dedicate Genesis Illegal Alien to Donald Trump. I mean...
he'll be president soon, right?
Yep.
Right.
I think he'll like this song.
Just a few days from now, huh?
Yep.
I wonder if he likes Genesis.
I bet he does. Who doesn't like Genesis?
Dunno, really.
Everyone loves Genesis.
You think
so? Well, maybe not everyone. There's a lot of sides to Genesis. There's the early 70s sort of flutes and boots, masks, 30 minutes long song, Genesis.
Hey, he was wearing masks.
Yeah, Peter Gabriel.
Oh, right, I remember him.
Yeah.
Right.
And then there's the Phil Collins Genesis, which is kind of the pop side of Genesis. Big fan of his drumming. I'm a big fan of his drumming.
Weren't he the drummer?
He was the drummer.
Right.
And then he went out front and started singing, which is always a good idea when a drummer does that, isn't it?
He could do both.
He was just the drummer, and then he became the singer.
Only the good ones can do that, mate.
You got to be good.
You've got to be really good to do that.
Really, really good to do that.
Don't see that happen too often.
Only a few times has it really worked out beneficially.
Wait a minute.
Oh, I'd be delivering pizzas if it didn't happen in the 90s.
You, Don't you have an album?
Yeah, you've got
one too.
Our singer's a drummer at heart. It started out as the drummer.
I've got an idea.
Yeah.
How about we play the Genesis song?
I like that.
Right?
Yeah.
And then we play a Taylor Hawkins song.
Oh, boy.
Right?
Okay. Which one? I know which one.
I like this tune called Bob Quit His Job.
Yeah. That's
it's catchy.
It's annoying.
It's great.
The most annoying song I've ever written.
I think it's great. All right.
It's going to sound real good next to Illegal Alien.
Let's find out.
Let's do it.
All right.
Was that almost dead air?
You're listening to Jonesy's Jukebox.
Yes.
There's a lot of that.
Yeah.
Dead air. All right, then.
Off we go. Genesis Land.
Let's hear it. You're listening to Jonesy's Jukebox, KLOS.
95.5.
That's right. It's 95.5.
I've been listening for years. So long.
They're nice people.
They're nice people.
They gave me a show.
I mean, why wouldn't they?
Well, who's crazy enough to give good old Jonesy a show?
Well, I mean, everyone I know loves Jonesy's Jukebox. I love your laugh, Jonesy. I love it.
Thank you. It's so
recognizable. That could be no one else but you. That could be no one else but Jonesy, you know? That's no one but Jonesy right there.
Well, you know.
It's unmistakable, undeniable.
So that was Bob Quit His Job.
Correct. That's about my old neighbor, Bob, who quit his job, for sure.
You wrote a song about it, didn't you?
I did. Every lyric's about him completely. Ah. And in there, he liked the Grateful Dead. I hate the Grateful Dead, sorry. But he loves
them. Everybody knows that now. She's not like Grateful Dead.
I hate the fact that I love them so much. Anyways, so we would argue a lot.
I'm not buying that one.
We would argue about, because he was very much did not like Queen. Ah. And I didn't like the Grateful Dead. So we would have these arguments over barbecues, like, you know. So in the lyric I say, grateful that the dead never died, because for him the dead never died. You know, the Grateful Dead, even though, I don't know, it's stupid.
That's deep, Taylor.
That's deep. I was digging. Wow. Thanks, Bob. Thanks for the inspiration, if you're out there not working.
Did you get another job?
No, he didn't. His wife works a lot now, and so he just, like, plays golf and putters around the house.
Yeah. Embarrassing him right now.
No, I think he actually feels like, haha, I don't have to work, you do.
Plus, he's got a song about it.
And he's got a song that they play on KLOS once.
It's catchy.
A century.
It's great.
It's great. Thanks,
buddy. I like it. It's great.
Thanks, buddy.
It's a great song.
I worked hard on it.
Phil Collins, too.
Yeah. Well, that was Genesis earlier, wasn't it?
Oops.
Yep. It's hard to tell who's who, and, you know, there's Phil Collins, there's Genesis, and Never the Twain Shall Meet. There's that unmistakable laugh again. I mean, that's just Jonesy. You can't ever... That's it.
All right, then.
What are we going to do now, man? What are we going to do now?
I don't know.
We got to do something, man.
There's another song.
I suppose.
What
do we got lined up there? ELO, that's right. Okay, yeah, this is for my daughter. She loves the movie Xanadu, featuring Olivia Newton-John and some other dude.
I remember her.
Yep, I love her. We still love her, and we still listen a lot. And she loves that album, the soundtrack, Xanadu. And ELO did most of the music for it, I think. But they have this crazy song on there called I'm Alive. And I thought, what the heck? I heard it. We listened to it this weekend, so this is for my little baby girl.
What was that movie about then?
Xanadu. Isn't it about like a space chick comes down and roller discos or something like that? I don't think I've ever watched the whole thing. I just watched parts of it.
Was they roller skating?
There's a roller skating theme.
I like roller skating.
It's very late 70s. It was like, you know, it was that thing. It was like, you know, remember the Battle of the Network Stars? It was like that kind of time period.
Oh, right.
You know? You weren't, do you remember that? Yeah, you were here by then, no?
Well, I think so. I like roller skating.
Well, this may bring some roller skating to mind.
All right, then.
So I have a go.
What's the name of the song again?
It's called I'm Alive by ELO.
Who's singing?
It's Jeff Lynne.
Actually. Oh.
It's ELO.
I remember him.
Yeah, yeah. He's great.
He's from ELO.
He's from ELO.
Right. He was in that movie. No,
he wasn't in a movie. No, he made the music.
He was
part of the musical side of
it. About roller skating.
With Olivia,
which
John.
I like. I like roller skating.
I can imagine you roller skating.
Yeah, it's great. It's great. All right, then. What's the name of this song?
It's called I'm Alive.
All right, let's hear it. Jonesy's Jukebox, 95.5
KLOS. 95.5 KLOS.
All right.
That's some trippy stuff, man.
That's my bloody Valentine.
That's some trippy stuff, man.
You're listening to Jonesy's Jukebox. And I'm here with Taylor Hawkins from the Foo Fighters. Hello, Taylor.
How's it going, Jonesy?
All right.
This is nice. We get to hang out a lot lately. We were last week, remember?
That's right. It was great.
This is a killer job, dude. Sit around, play records, and hang out with your bros.
Yeah. It's all right. It's not bad.
It's nice. It's nice.
I play anything I want.
And they pay $1 million a year to do that, too. That's insane.
Free. Free million.
Free million.
Free.
Free $1 million.
Yeah.
Free $1 million.
You know how much shilajit I can buy with $3 million?
A lot of shilajit.
That is a lot of shilajit. It's a mineral.
That's a lot of minerals.
Well, you know, I've got a cleanse.
Is it cleansing you?
Dunno, really. I feel all right.
You look cleansed. Look very clean inside.
Thanks. Thanks, Taylor.
Not emitting any horrible odors or anything. It must be working.
You think I smell nice?
You
do. Oh, thanks.
Yeah.
That's nice of you.
Yeah. Yep. You're good.
Right. Do you know what that is?
Shilajit.
That's right. That's me smell.
I hope you're getting some free shilajit out of all this.
Maybe they should be a sponsor.
Shilajit sponsor.
Jonesy's Jukebox, brought to you by shilajit. It's a mineral.
You know, and right. It cleanses you.
I feel all right.
There you go.
What
do we got up next?
Well... How about, did you pick one?
Well, yeah.
Who?
ZZ Top.
Who them?
Three boys from great state of Texas.
Ah, I remember them.
That's where I was from, Texas.
Right.
So,
They're the ones with the beards.
With the beards. And the funny thing is, you know, here's the neat thing about ZZ Top.
Right.
The two guys that have the long beards.
With the beards.
Yeah.
Right.
Their last name's not Beard. But the drummer, who has no beard, guess what his last name is?
Jones.
No.
What?
Beard. Isn't that funny? Think they did that on purpose?
Wait a second.
Two dudes with the beards.
Right.
Are not named Beard. But the dude with no beard has a beard. That's the truth.
I'm a bit confused.
Me too.
Really?
Me too.
I'm not sure what you're saying.
It's the facts.
Jack. All right.
This song's called Heard It on the X. I don't believe it.
Heard It on the X?
Heard It on the X. I don't know what that means.
Great drummer.
Great drummer. Great. Great. Frank.
Without a beard. He's
Frank
not
Beard.
Got a
and his
beard.
His name's Frank Beard, and his name and he doesn't have a beard, and the other guy's got beards.
Is that irony?
Isn't it ironic?
Don't you think?
I do.
All right. Let's hear it then.
95.5.
Jonesy's jukebox. Mine is nice.
That's nice. It's got a good feel.
It's tight.
It is.
I like it.
A good feel.
You're listening to Jonesy's Jukebox on KLOS. I'm here with Taylor Hawkins. All right, Taylor?
Yeah. What a day, huh? Gorgeous.
Dave Clark 5, huh?
Yeah.
All right.
You like them, right?
I remember them.
Of course. Glad All Over. They had a couple hits.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That drummer, though.
I don't really
know. He's a bit loose.
He's a bit loose. And the funny thing is, Dave Clark was the drummer.
How many of them were there?
I mean, I think there were 5 of them.
Was there actually 5?
I think it was the Dave Clark 5.
Oh, right.
I don't know if that was including him or Dave Clark 5s. Dave Clark and the 5.
I've got a question.
Yeah.
If someone quits,
it's the Dave Clark 4.
Right.
Yeah.
They'd have to change all the t-shirts.
Yeah, that'd be a...
Change all the merchandise.
Be a bumble up.
Bumble up?
I just made that up right there. It sounded English to me. A bumble up. You ever said that? No.
No.
Bumble up. Sounds like some kind of food.
That's like something you'll have for breakfast.
A bumble up. Mom, can we have a bumble up, please?
I like a nice bumble up in the morning.
Bumble up.
Except now I'm on a cleanse.
So no bumble up for you.
No. No thanks.
No thanks for the bumble up. What are we listening to?
Jonesy's Jukebox.
On 95. KLOS. Yeah, just gotta say it every once in a while. Don't you? Isn't that like part of the deal? Every like, what is it? Every what? 10 every 10 minutes? 15. Oh, okay. So we've been saying it too much, maybe. I don't know what I'm doing. You're the king.
I haven't got a clue what's going on. Ever. Really. I just come in.
That's the charm, really, isn't it?
I think so.
Apparently.
I think that's why people like Jonesy's Jukebox.
Because it sounds like nobody knows what's going on the whole time.
It's dead air.
Yeah.
Sometimes. It's fun to... Say you're on the 405.
Yeah.
Traffic.
Bin.
And you just need to chill.
Chew?
Chill.
Chew what?
You know, no, not chew. Chill.
Oh, chill, sorry.
Right. Let's play a song.
Should we?
I think so.
When are we going to do an Irish 2 for Tuesday?
Is it Tuesday?
It is.
Oh. Let's play 2 songs. How about...
Which one's coming
what
first?
What was them called? Thin Lizzy.
Thin and Wispy?
Thin Wispy. Like your hair.
Thin Wispy.
Thin Wispy. Right. What's this song called?
Bad Reputation.
Wait a sec. It's not a Joan Jett song, is it?
No.
Oh.
It was the one before, I think, I would say.
You think it came first?
With all due respect, I believe so. I think it did. But, yeah, I mean, come on. There can be more than one bad reputation. A lot of people have bad reputations.
Not me, mate.
Not you. Not you. Good.
Squeaky clean.
Squeaky clean.
I've never done a bad thing in my life.
There you go.
Uh-uh.
There you go, then. Squeaky clean.
Thin Lizzy.
Bad reputation.
I remember them.
Yeah.
All right, let's hear it.
Phil Lynott.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, there you are.
He played bass.
Yep.
Oh, he was great. I remember him. All right. It's Fen Lazy. Bad Reputation. Jonesy's Jukebox. 95.5. KLOS. All right.
I love that. I love that. That was one of my favorite bands when I was a kid.
Ooh.
You too.
Oh, right. Damn. Yeah. I remember them. You too.
Yeah.
From Ireland.
Indeed.
Do you know what?
So is Thin Lizzy.
Yeah.
Thin Lizzy.
Thin Wispy.
Thin Wispy.
It's like your hair.
Yeah. Whatever, dude. Nice and full.
It looks great.
For 45-year-old.
It looks great. It's all right, Taylor. I like your hair.
Trying.
It's nice.
Trying to look good. Yeah, you too. That reminds me of, I don't know why, I don't like early U2, me and my lady, we listen to a lot of that at home. It reminds me of winter. I don't know why, that's why we listen to it during the winter. Because they were always cruising around in the snow.
Ain't they got an album with them in the snow?
They definitely had a video with them in the snow.
I feel like I've seen a picture of them.
Yeah.
With jackets and mittens and hats.
They're cold.
Yeah.
It's cold.
Ireland
gets cold.
It's cold there.
I wonder where they shot that video where they're walking around in the snow hitting a drum. Probably like Wisconsin or something.
Yeah, maybe that. Do you know, that song was live.
It was indeed. Under a Blood Red Sky.
I remember that record.
Yeah. Remember the videos? Bono with the gnarliest mullet of all time.
Oh, right. Yeah, it was like Mad Max mullet.
Some Beyond Thundertone.
Yeah.
What is it?
Welcome. Post-apocalyptic mullet.
Yeah.
I think, I remember that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I had one.
Did you have a mullet?
For sure.
Was it thin and wispy?
No. It was thin and wispy on the sides, not in the back.
Right. Was it a socko rocker?
It was a lobster.
Oh.
Or you could call it the Canadian passport. There's a lot of different names.
Was it a neck cape? It was a neck cape.
A neck cape.
Oh, right. One of those.
It was business in front, party in the back.
I ain't never had a mullet. Or did I?
I don't know. Did you?
I did. I don't think so.
They were all the rage.
Right.
Mullet really was the thing to have around 1984.
I think it might be coming back.
You know, let's just drive down to Silver Lake after this and we'll see if it's coming back.
Maybe what's that festival? Coachella.
Coachella.
Is that what that is?
Yeah.
With mullets.
Did they go? Is there lots of mullets at Coachella now?
Don't know, really.
We should go out there and take. Not old Chella. That's just because you're bald on top.
That's the one you see Thin Wispy playing.
Yeah.
Right.
I don't think you're going to see Thin Wispy playing anymore.
No?
No, Phil Lynott.
Oh, right.
Yeah.
I remember him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Couple good nights.
I don't know. You'll have to read my book.
Definitely in the queue. It's in the queue.
Have you seen my book?
You gave me one last week, remember?
Right.
Right, right.
I did, huh?
You gave me and Dave and Pat one.
What was it called?
Lonely Boy, I believe, is the title, right?
Like that Andrew Gold song.
Like the Andrew Gold song that Dave played. Dave liked that song a lot. That's why he played that.
He's a wanker, though.
He
ain't no good.
No, he's the best. No good. He's the king.
No.
Come on, man.
No, he ain't no good.
My best pal, dude. You can say that.
Well, that's nice of you to say.
He's
a bit thin and wispy, too.
Well,
he's old.
He's not as old as you, Jonesy.
Hey. Watch that. It's my show.
That's true.
It's my show.
You can kick me out anytime.
All right, let's play a song then. Which one? What have we got?
What have we got on the... And then what? Sugarloaf.
Sugarloaf.
Yeah, and I thought that's what we were having for lunch.
He's joking. He's joking.
I am. I'm joking.
What was their song they had?
It's called Green-Eyed Dude.
No. That's not it. Green-Eyed Bird.
Green-Eyed Bird. Green-Eyed Bird.
Oh, no. Green-Eyed Lady. That's what it was.
Green-Eyed Dame.
I like this song.
All right, let's have a go.
It's great.
What are we listening to? Oh, 95.
It's Jonesy's Jukebox.
95. Kids.
That was Queens of the Stone Age.
It was indeed.
I like them.
So do I. Love them.
Nice guys, too.
Fab.
Yeah.
Fab guys.
That was called Something's in the Wolf.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I wonder what was in the wolf.
Something trippy.
Something trippy was in the wolf.
Got a bit strange there for a moment.
Someone's acid was in the wolf.
Right.
Can you eat on radio?
Yeah.
This is a great cheeseburger.
How's that burger?
Great.
What have you got on it? You seem a bit picky to me. Are you a picky eater?
You mean, do I pick what I like to eat? Yes, I do.
you seem like the type of guy who would go to a drive-thru and argue about the onions on your burger. Is that right?
Well,
come on now.
I would ask to not have onions on
there. Would you like some water?
Whatever. Here.
You seem a bit clogged up.
I'm good.
Maybe you might need a cleanse.
Can I have some of your Shinjuku or whatever?
Shilajit. It's a mineral.
Oh yeah.
Right. It's good. It's good for you. You might want some.
I need to get some Shilajit. You can hook me up after today, I think.
I think I've got a lifetime supply now.
I'm going to have a lifetime supply of Shilajit.
You're listening to Jonesy's Jukebox on KLOS 95.5. I'm here with Taylor Hawkins of the Foo Fighters. And do you want to play a song?
Yes, I do.
All right, then. Let's hear...
What do you want to play? What do we got?
Black Rebel. Oh, one of my favorites.
Yeah. My buddy Dave is buddies with those guys.
Yeah, but he's a wanker, though.
No, could you quit saying Dave's a wanker, please?
I don't like him.
Yeah, you do. You were just here with him last week.
His hair's all...
Buddy.
His hair's all thin and wispy.
Well, so's mine, apparently.
He's getting old.
Well, so are you.
He's getting old. Wait a minute.
I'm sorry. I wasn't trying to be mean.
All right, then. Black Rebel Motorcycle Club.
Let's hear it.
A song called Red Eyes and Tears. All right, then. I like that song.
Yep.
That's a nice one. Black Rebel Motorcycle Club.
It's really uplifting stuff.
I like it. You're listening to Jonesy's Jukebox, and we've got a visitor.
Finally, he shows up.
Hey, guys. Sorry I'm late. It's traffic.
Dude, you've been late, you know.
I know, but I've been listening. It's been great. It's been fantastic. What a show. I love the playlist you guys pick too.
Well, you know, we had you in mind.
That's very nice of you to say. I thought you might like that.
I did. I thought it was great. How cool. Was it fun, Taylor?
We had a blast.
Did you?
Jonesy said a lot of nice stuff about you.
You know, I was actually listening on the 405.
Yeah. I mean,
Jonesy, you did not. Yeah. I thought you liked me.
Jonesy, you owe him an apology.
I'm sorry, Dave. You seem like a nice enough guy. I'm sorry. Yeah, that's okay.
You're talking crud.
Yeah.
When you're not here.
You know what I mean? And then you see him in real life, and he's the nicest guy in the world. Yeah, let's jam sometime.
I'm going to try not, be late next time. That's for sure.
No, man. That's not like that. That's not cool. Taylor?
Yes?
Did you have fun?
A blast. And I got a free cheeseburger out of the deal, too.
Yeah, you guys got cheeseburgers? That's not cool.
So good, too.
What a chip.
They're so good.
Is there really?
So chow.
They got another one in the little green room for me?
No.
Sorry, mate.
I got a couple fries left if you want to.
Yeah, Taylor, you should share your fries with them. Your chips. Give them a chip.
Have a chip.
Give me a chip, Taylor. Thanks, pal.
Have a chip.
Well, I'm sorry I missed it. It sounds like you guys had a really good time. Oh, well. Next time. Maybe we'll come back and do it. What do you think?
That sounds like a nice idea. Anytime, Dave. You're not a wanker.
Thanks, Steve.
Yeah, been good fries.
A good fries, right?
Yeah, good fries.
A good fry.
Yeah.
Or the old, you know, the crisp cut. Not crisp cut, but, you know, like the ones you get.
It's like high school cafeteria fries.
High school cafeteria fries.
Right there. Yeah. I like them when they get cold.
Yeah.
They're like little crayons.
Yeah.
Like potato crayons.
Are those O'Rettas?
All right. I'm not sure. All right. I don't want to interrupt. You guys do your thing.
Well, let's end, Jonesy, with a song that was recorded right next to you guys when you guys were recording Nevermind the Bollocks. So I've heard in legend. It's, I don't know, maybe a Queen's reaction to you guys recording next door to them is a song written It's a song written by Queen, by Roger Taylor, the drummer of Queen, one of my heroes.
I remember them.
Yeah.
Queen.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. Who was the singer?
Freddie Mercury. Farouk Balsara, or otherwise known as Freddie Mercury.
God bless you. What? What'd you just say?
That's his real name, Farouk Balsara.
Farouk.
Farouk. Farouk Balsara.
Farouk is on fire. all right, then. Well, thanks for listening, and we'll see you again next time. Dave, thanks for finally showing up.
Anything for you, Jonesy?
That was great. I feel kind of psycho right now.
It's a little weird. I feel like, what was that movie, Stepdad?
No, Stepfather.
Stepfather.
Wait a second. Who am I here?
That was a weird one. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Dave Grohl from the Foo Fighters.
Playing Jonesy.
I've been playing Jonesy for the last two hours. That wasn't really Jonesy. You know what? I know. Everyone's like, wait a minute. I thought that was Steve Jones from the Sex. He sounds so English.
Can't we hear the laugh one more time? that's
where people are like, Maybe it really is Steve Jones.
I thought he was here.
Really?
For whenever you laugh like that.
You saying I look like Steve Jones?
Mm-hmm.
Steve Jones,
back
I love
in 1988.
You. Jonesy. good answer. Thank you very much, everybody, for listening. That was really fun. We're going to listen to a Rush song now.
Nope.
Anthem.
Nope.
I'm sorry. Bad part. Queen.
off News of the World.
Right.
Sure, Heart Attack, their punk rock song. Go.
All right, then. Thanks for listening.